Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Force Quit. My name's The Hammer, and today we're going to take a look at a game called Valley. So, Valley is the newest game from the company who made Slender the Arrival. It's an indie game, obviously, and it came out three days ago. To start out with, it seems kind of like it might be like a walking sim kind of game, but there's a lot more to it than that once you actually get into it. I've played fairly well into it, maybe an hour or two. It's not a super long game. I want to say it's most people beat it in about 5-6 hours tops. So I'm gonna start a brand new one, obviously, and we'll take a look at that here today. So let's get started. This is just a brand new game. And I kind of like it. I like the aesthetic. I don't know if it's an amazing game, but I guess we'll see. So the load times aren't the best, even though I'm on a brand spanking new computer with a solid state drive. Somehow the load times just don't really want to do what they need to do, but whatever, it is what it is. So basically you play a surveyor, kind of archaeologist dude, looking for a life seed. This right here on the screen is pretty much what you're looking for. It's kind of the whole game.
Hey, looks like I missed you. I just wanted to wish you luck before you headed out. I still can't believe you're doing this. I mean, hunting down the... what was it? The life seed? You gotta admit, that sounds crazy. I mean, even if this mythological thing that can shatter worlds or whatever actually exists, what are the chances of you tracking down this ancient relic in the middle of the Rocky Mountains? Listen, I know you want to prove the thing exists. I get that. It's an adventure. Hell, it's your career, but can't you do something normal like the rest of us and just backpack Europe or something? Spend a month in Thailand? But hey, if by some miracle you find this thing and become the most famous archaeologist of all time, beers are on me. I'll even trade in your tinfoil hat for a whip and fedora. I just really hope all those canoeing lessons pay off.
Apparently not. So yeah, here we are, right out the gate. Canadian Rockies. And its controls are pretty simple. It's standard FPS WASD to move around, mouse control to move, space will eventually be jump, and shift is run. As of right now, you can't jump yet. And the actual mouse sensitivity is way too high to start. It's actually kind of annoying. Alright, let's try that. Let me just wiggle this around here real quick. Turn the music down because the music's like blisteringly loud too. So here we go. So obviously from the start, it looks like you're going to be walking around. They do a real good job with the waterfalls and with the like foliage in the game. So you're all very much on a rail through a lot of the intro here. But it picks up pretty quickly, so there's more to it than meets the eye. So yeah, you're in a valley in the Canadian Rockies, trying to find the life seed. There's not a whole lot of explanation right out the gate. You saw what it was. That's all the context you get. And like I said, it's very much kind of a walking simulator right out the gate. You pick the game up and you're like, oh great, is this another one of those? Seems all peaceful and nice, right? What about these skulls? What's going on with these little forest nymphs? What's up, dudes? Come back here, I just want to look at you. I just want to give you a look. I like how in the beginning you pick if you're male or female, and it specifically says voice, and then your character just doesn't talk. I mean, maybe the body changes or something. But I'm pretty sure you just never talk. It just shows up on screen. So right about here is where the game gets a little more interesting. You get your leaf suit, and this is pretty much the point of the game. At this point, it kind of turns into like a first-person kind of Sonic the Hedgehog-style game, believe it or not. Sonic the Hedgehog Puzzler, I guess? So they're going to give us some background on the suit. I feel like this part tries a little too hard. And it's unskippable too, so. I guess we'll just sit here and watch, huh? More like leafing high. So yeah, now you can jump, and it's actually kind of a cool mechanic idea. Like what they add here is you can kill things and you can bring things to life.
Virginia King, audio journal, June 4th, 1941.
So the jumping at this point is pretty good. I actually like it a lot.
By the army to study the history of this valley. The mysterious forest sprites seem to be the last living remnants of the long-lost culture that once lived here. A large number of them seem to inhabit the northeast sector of the valley, just past the ruins where the light seeps.
See, stuff like this?
Rumored to possess an earth-shattering
That's fun.
Power.
That's super fun. Like, the actual platforming and the running is fun. Like, the sense of speed is legit. See what I mean? Like, the sense of speed's legit. It feels like, as I said, it feels like a frickin' Sonic the Hedgehog game. And it feels more so like it coming up soon, because there's little orbs that you can collect to get more energy. Like, it... Yeah. It's called Amrita. So, this is like the other gameplay mechanic, is you can bring things to life, and later on you can take life away. So you can bring all these trees back to life, using some of your energy there. The bar's up in the upper, what is the upper left corner there. And oh no, there's a dead deer. Oh no. Probably got hit by a car, the stupid shit, but come on, bro. That's right. You'd be happy to be alive, because it's because of me. The platforming feels pretty good. I almost want to call it like Metroid Prime, but you don't have quite as much air control. I guess it's that first-person, like, platform feel. So yeah, these orbs, like, these just feel like rings in Sonic the Hedgehog. And it seems like it's kind of going to be like either a walking simulator or an endless runner, and there's, like I said, there's more to it than that. It's just the tutorial kind of feels like that right out the gate. But yeah, it's this game's real good about giving you a sense of speed when you have it. And by far the best parts are when you can run like that. You can also take a life away, and at this point, this is when it lets you do it. So if you run out of energy, you can always just kill a tree. You absorb its energy, and that's that. You can kill, I assume you can kill a deer. Where is he? I thought I heard one running. Oh, hey. Doink. Suck it, deer. You're dead. Now you're alive. Whoa-ho. Could you imagine just fucking with something like that? You're alive. You're dead. You're alive. You're dead. Alright, let's collect some energy here so I actually have enough to do what I need to do. What's kind of weird is you're supposedly playing back, like, a single audio log, and yet they just pop up at random as needed in the game. Can I kill these little dudes? Oh shit, I can. Oh, I kinda didn't mean that, bro. Look at him! He's a ghost. You can go back to life. Yay! He's so excited about it. Yeah, when this game hits, it hits right on point. So these little guys are energy upgrades. If you collect four of them, you get another whole little pocket of energy. And you come across little written logs from the other people who've been here before. The army in the 40s, I guess. So there we go. Ta-da! I have three energy now. So yeah, the name of this game is Mobility, very much. It's all about how fast and how far you can move at any given time.
Luckily for me, the military is helping to explore all these ruins through the soldiers pilot in leaf suits. They call these soldiers pathfinders, so they can trek through terrain normally inaccessible to someone like me. Every guy back home's gonna wanna go joyriding in a leaf suit. But until the military's project comes to a close, we're cut off from any contact outside the valley. I guess the world will have to wait just a bit longer to get their hands on these rides.
Okay, good. Alright. I was gonna say, first time I played through here, I didn't take that little side track, and I wanted to see what was over here. So there's little medallions which are said to be used to access an ancient pyramid. It doesn't say anything about how many there are or anything like that. I haven't gotten far enough to see. But these acorns are used to open doors later on. Like, fairly soon later on, actually. So. The sense of speed's pretty great, especially because you can just slam through broken and cracked floors like this. And just slide on down. So, I'm not a huge fan of what LEAF stands for the LEAF suit. Like, the military would have ever named something LEAF and called it a Leap Effortlessly Through Air Functionality suit. It's pretty clearly a backronym, and that's kind of annoying, but it's all right. I don't know, I'm being too picky about like the lore of a game made by the people who made a Slender Man video game, I guess. I guess that's just me.
Just what are these glowing orbs that everyone is making a fuss over? They're absolutely beautiful. They seem to grow randomly throughout the valley. I know nothing about them other
See, I
than that
like
they're
the
seen in
graphics
the
are nice.
valley
I like
as
them a lot.
armies
There's the
of
sun sticking through there. It's got
warlocks,
little rays of light and
and
just
that
shaft
must
coming
not
in.
help me.
Oh.
Such a shame.
Yeah. So
I'm
you die
sure
in the water.
that
Like the minute you touch the water, you die. And the other thing is when you die, the valley loses life. And if the valley loses too much life, you can't be brought back to life. There's actually a tutorial part, like right up here, where they teach you all that stuff. I'm actually kind of surprised you can die before that. But yeah, the sense of movement and like agility that you get once you really get trucking is pretty great. That part is super, super fun. So yeah, like right here, this is where you die, and the game explains the death mechanic in the game. Oh no, I fell. And see, the valley loses some health when you die. So basically, you die and you get like quantum rewound back to the earlier stage before you died. That's pretty much all there is to it. And I think once the valley runs out of health, that's the end of it. I don't know if you can actually heal the valley at all, or maybe it's per level or something. So like the things around you will die. I'm trying to see if that gives the valley more life or not. Like it'd be nice if it did. Like bringing the trees back to life and stuff. Oh, it does. Okay, cool. That might work out to an interesting mechanic. You collect the like gems. Collect the gems around you, and you bring the valley more life as you get killed. Like in exchange for bringing you back. That might work out to be cool in some of the harder puzzles. I haven't gotten to the point where that's been an issue though. So yeah. So from here, this is where it starts to get a little less linear. You can follow the roots of the tree to each of these obelisks. There's three of them you got to do first, and you can bring some life back to the tree. It's definitely a game all about nature and like the preservation of it and that sort of thing. So yeah, over here. Let's go hit up these obelisks, huh? Need to upgrade my suit as much as possible. Yeah, they were a decent people. Look at that. Big giant head just hanging out. So we'll bring the tree back to life, and it's cool. It kind of travels down the roots like electric, like an electrical current, and the tree gets bigger. I'm just gonna go land on the head here. Let's head to the next one. I guess I can do the middle guy here first. Actually, you know what? I don't even know what's over this way. Over this away. Let's go exploring, shall we? I don't know that there is anything over here, but they built it for a reason. That goes way down. Okay. Whoa! See, the speed is great, and I just slammed into a wall, but whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna go handle this obelisk here. Gotta give life back to the valley. Ooh. Yeah, see, there's a lot of running. That is most of the game. Oh, you know what? I gotta start at the top so I can jump through that. Get my speed up and smash it.
According to legend, the life seed is said to be a bringer of death on a global scale, splintering the earth into fragments. Such end time scenarios are common across mythologies, from the apocalypse to Ragnarok. However, it's unusual for the event to surround a particular object, especially one acquired.
I'm one away from an upgrade here. Let's watch the tree grow. See, it's kind of cool. The aesthetic's cool. Pretty sure there's no falling damage. I've dropped pretty far. I think that's kind of the point of the leaf suit here. You look down and watch yourself run. See your little goofy legs. Alright, so I need three acorns to get through this door, and I'm pretty sure... Yeah, I got eight, so I should be good here.
The playful little sprites of this valley, which I've come to call demons, are...
I love that. These playful little sprites, which I call demons!
But without a zoologist on site, I'm mostly coming up dry.
Oh, shit. Yeah, almost didn't make that.
So the army tends to ignore them as they go about their research. I wonder if the world would clamor to have these daemons as pets.
Yes, I bet. The whole world would be like, I want a demon!
Better than all those feral cats in her backyard, anyways.
Give me those acorns. Yeah, the name demons will have to do until a zoologist comes along and names them not demons. Whoop. Is there a box in here? Nope. Alright. That's a really big tree. Like, really big. Let's see if I can get some size context over next to it here, but yeah, that's the tree I just did. I just gave it a lot more life. I think I can take it away too, but I don't know what that does, so I'm not gonna do it. At this point you go underneath the tree. Arrgh. I guess that's a voice. I guess I picked that.
The land here isn't arable, yet the population that lived here was clearly sedentary in nature. This leads me to believe this place was used as a sacred ground. Are these monuments to the mythical cannibal giants of native lore? The Saiteka?
Yeah, that's what I want, is big cannibal giants. Please, let me fight some of those. All right. right, so I think this is the first... Yeah, this is where you get the first upgrade. So, like, the suit's... you're not just done with the suit as soon as you get it. This gives me double jump, and Lord knows any game that gives you a double jump is usually a pretty good game. Gotta say. Gotta say it. Uses a little bit of energy to do the jump, but whatever.
Andrew Fisher, lead physicist. Beginning Pathfinder testing on the Icarus boost upgrade. The secondary boost augmentation to the leaf suit should allow a Pathfinder to jump twice in sequence through the air.
Through the air.
Height and distance of their leap drastically. Report any defects to a commanding officer immediately.
Yeah, I don't know. Any game that gives me a double jump, I tend to like. So, apparently there is a pyramid here. I haven't gotten to the point where you see it yet, but, yeah. Got a double jump! Hup. Ain't nothing wrong with any video game that lets me jump twice. Weep. Just, the more mobility you can have in the air, the better in pretty much any game.
Apparently, the military was just as excited as they immediately confiscated it to study at the Soma facility on the mountaintop. They won't let me anywhere near it.
Damn military. Taking my life seed, see? You know? Let's get through these caves and get back outside. This jump here is kind of cool. Maximum momentum. Like, that kind of shit feels great in this game. It feels great. You know, I'm gonna turn this brightness up a little bit. I don't know how it looks for you guys, but I'm playing it windowed right now and it gets a little dark. There we go. I don't know, that jump really feels good. Get that upgrade. Hell yeah. Alright, so right about here is where the first like enemies that you can actually fight are. They call them Amrita Swarms. They're not too bad. Yet. Obviously, if there's more than one, they're probably not great, but... There you go. That's pretty much all you do. You shoot him with the life gun, and then you can jump through him to reload your energy. I don't think that ever cancels it out. It might, but I don't know. I've never actually had to do it yet. So let's head up.
If there's one thing I could do without in this valley, it's those damn Amrita swarms that seem to infect this place.
Whoop. Here's my next upgrade. This gives me a full thing energy, I think, right? Yeah. Use Amrita generators. Doink! That's a loud elevator, I gotta say. And there's not really, like, a context for the time frame in which this is happening. It looks like maybe in the 80s somewhere, based on the computer that was shown during the intro. But it's quite a bit after all of this stuff was built. A Gotta get that quantum immortality. Let's get to the top here. Ruh-roh. God, could you imagine being an elevator dropping like that? IRL, I would shit my pants. I'm not even gonna pretend. And that tree's so big that you can still see it up through the clouds. Yeah, I can't imagine why. Hey, this old man found a place in northern Canada where there's demons. How he came to discover this place is beyond me. Anything else over here to get? I'm trying to get all the upgrades. I get the feeling like I won't regret it later, I guess. You know what? I might need to cut this fucking pinky nail, because you gotta hold down the shift key to run all the time. It's kind of bugging me. Just to be safe, get that double jump. There you go. Take care of those swarms. So this is the part where it started screaming like Metroid Prime to me. I don't know what it is about jumping from little mid-air platform to mid-air platform with a double jump that screams GameCube shooter, but... I do kind of wish that the double jump didn't take up some of your energy. Like, that part seems to be... I mean, I get why, but still. The next one over this way. Yeah, see, when you're actually up and moving, this game feels great. It's when you have to slow down a little bit that it's not as wonderful. Yeah, that's an interesting flag. What was that? I'm just checking something real quick here. Checking out the stream quality. Yeah, it looks fine. Cool. Alright, let's run fast. I don't know if you guys knew this, but, gotta go fast. Where is it? Right there. There's some kind of ruins over that way. Wonder if you end up over there. Probably. I mean, it would be kind of cool to have this kind of, like, running suit that lets you jump like a maniac. Like, that'd be super cool. Especially if it lets me double jump IRL. Maybe then I'll finally be able to dunk. I really am tall enough where I should probably actually be able to dunk, but I'm just too fat. Too fat and too lazy. What's it say? Shadowy figures watching our operations. Give me those upgrades. Is there another thing here? Nope, just a hole in the wall. Okay. Keel. Let's get trucking. Trucking down the pipes. That's how you know it's a video game, because you're running in a fucking sewer. Yes, they do. Swing yourself up to new paces with the Viper Coil. I don't know how to use the Viper Coil. Onto Deadeye Crane Blocks. Okay, cool. While targeting a Deadeye. It's an incredible experience.
The Viper Coil upgrade to the Leaf Suit allows Pathfinders to grapple onto certain target points within a limited range. Allowing them to reach areas.
Oh, is that why it changes red and blue? Okay. That makes sense.
The Viper Coil is currently limited to particular targets.
Yes, for testing purposes. AKA because it's a video game. Whoa! Okay. I'm on board with that. I'm also on board with any game that gives me a grapple beam, I'm not gonna lie. Give me those acorns! Doesn't feel as fast as I would like, though. Alright, how many do you need? 5? I got 19. Open up. Crane block overhead. Yes, there is. We've got a large portion of this valley mapped out. As far as I know, we've explored most of the acorn doors. Almost enough medallions to access the pyramid. I wonder if there's... Ah, man. I wonder if that's maybe like a secondary secret ending, is if you collect enough of those to open up the pyramid. I'd be kind of pissed if you couldn't, like, always get to it. Whoa! See, that shit's fun. Hey, what's up, another... whatever it is. Is that a door? Is that an acorn door? Looks like an acorn door. How many are you? 12. I got 12? I got acorns for days. I like how all these guys already got through these doors, and yet somehow they're all still there. Weird, huh? What do we got here? Another upgrade. Yeah, give me that energy. That seems like an optional door. Hail to the yeah. It was worth collecting those acorns, see? Any dead trees around here? No. Yeah, I guess the grunt is boy versus girl voice, right? Oh, jeez. Let's just get out of that little pit there. Something over here? Give me them acorns. I almost wish I was farther north in the Canadian Rockies right now, like IRL, because it's blistering hot here. Still. I know I keep complaining about that, but it is very hot. What's up here? Anything? No, nothing. Well, can't say I didn't explore. See, it's kind of cool. You can see where you've already been. It's not like just a skybox thing. Nothing. Give me them upgrades. What do we got here? Why does that shine like that? Does that mean I break through it? Let's find out. Oh, it does. Yo, did this take me all the way back? Don't I want to go up? Yeah, alright, there we go. Yeah, the game's definitely going for a technology versus nature kind of dichotomy here. I wonder if I can run up that at some point. That'd be cool. Based on, like, just how loud and grating that sound is versus, like, how peaceful the nature part is. There's a little tree way out there. Whoa! Alright, I got that double jump, I'm good. Pathfinder training area. See, a lot of games would have started you in a training area, but I don't need to. Did Pathfinders train here? Yes, they did. Very good. You figured it out. Sign literally said Pathfinder training area.
I've often found myself in the company of a Pathfinder named Edwin Hall. The things he can do in a leaf suit are astounding.
Ooh, shit. Who's shooting at me? That's a hell of a range there, man. Yeah, sure do. Can I get this jump all the way over here? Nope. No, I cannot. Man, that is video game-ass dialogue if there ever was one. You run by a sign that says Pathfinder Training, and your character says, I wonder if the Pathfinder's trained here. So, what the fuck do you think? Well, guess I gotta climb back up. That's okay. I wanna find all these little secrets here anyway. Where's the next one? Probably this guy, right? There we go. Alright, let's be ready to shoot this dude. One of those Amrita swarms. One of them there Amrita swarms. Yeah, they're really not that brutal. They're more of a nuisance than anything so far. I mean, I'm sure at some point they'll start throwing more than one at me. Like, at a time. Like, that will probably get annoying. Book Riders! Where's the Book Riders? Where's my boys, the Book Riders? Valkyrie's Book Rider! David Hopkins. My man. That's my man, the Book Rider. Note from a Pathfinder. Well, that would suck. I gotta kill a bear. I'm gonna kill myself a bar. What's this? Observation area. What is it? Concentration requires silence. Yes, I'm sure the army's super concerned about silence. While people are training. Ooh, that's a fucking hell of a jump. Oh god, man. I gotta be better about that, man. I let go of that way too late. Like, my speed was already dying out at that point. Get the medallions. Get some more of those. What's over here? Hold the Viper Strike! Probably want to be moving faster when I do that, huh? Yeah, that's, that gets pretty close. Nothing to search there. What's over here? What's up in here? Give me those cogs. Or medallions, whatever you want to call them. These cogs of duties. Alright, there were now two signs warning me of an avalanche, or rocks falling, so I'm sure something's gonna happen there. Or one sign and then the sound of it. Another sound. Pendulum. What's up, little spirits? Hey, guys. How long has it been abandoned? Probably since the 40s, bro. Oh, those reload my energy. Okay. What we got here? So the soundtrack in this game is real good. I ain't got any complaints about that. Gotta be secrets around here somewhere, right? Maybe not. Oh, I can't fit in this one? I can fit in the other ones. Typical. Typical tunnels, too tight for a man of my stature. This is a hell of a facility to have built here. At the top of the Rocky Mountains in northern Canada. Can I just straight up get up there? Nope. Apparently not. Well, it's worth a try. Let's see. What do we got? Hey, why don't I go in the front door? Could probably try that, right? Nope. That doesn't work. These seem to light up when you get closer. I wonder if that's a thing. I wonder if there's like a puzzle involving them or something. See, I want upgrades before I go progressing too far, you know? I want to make sure I have all the energy packs I can carry and all that crap. Yep. And the medallions. Can't forget the medallions. How am I going to be a hype man without a medallion? I came from down that way, okay. If there's anything around the back, if they just modeled it for shits. Looks like they just modeled it for shits. Okay. Yeah, you gotta respect that. Yeah. You gotta respect that. They didn't have to model this. They could have made this inaccessible. Actually, you probably gotta go up top, so maybe they didn't. What a goofy. Look at his shadow. Aduh. I'm wearing big elf boots. Aduh. Alright, well. Clearly there's no upgrades over this way. Let's head back up. Restore a small amount. That's useful. What do we got up here? Oh no, I want to be on this. Yeah, it feels like a Sonic the Hedgehog slash, like, Metroid run.
I wish the military's presence here wasn't so domineering.
Honey, you wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the military.
Giant structures add much to the view. It would be nice if this was simply a place of study and conservation. I'm doing my best to steer the army away from the ruins, but...
Ooh, shit, that's a jump.
...to concern them is their project. Gathering up as many of these strange orbs.
Yeah. Ooh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, what? Oops. Whoopsie. Yeah, it feels like, oh, he's a stronger one, huh? He's green. Yeah, the running feels like a combination of Sonic the Hedgehog and, like, a Metroid... like, speed boost ability. Like, you go far enough, so you go fast enough. Well, clearly I gotta climb up there and drop down onto that. Maybe. Ooh, shit. I'm not going down there. Maybe I gotta, though. Hmm. What do we got here? Do I have to go down there? I kinda don't want to. I don't know if I want to do that. I want to go up there. Well, let's see what happens. Hey, hey! What's up, elevator? What's going on here? Oh yeah, I just bugged this bitch out. You're not supposed to go down here. I think I was supposed to die? Because this is the elevator I took to get up here, and now it's not letting me fall through it. There we go. Hmm. Shit, do I really gotta do that all over again? Okay, well. Let's do it a little quicker this time. I was hoping there was like a load option or something there, but there wasn't, so... Oh, that feels so good! Whatever, I can get back there pretty quickly. I know where I'm going this time. Yeah, it seems like once you know where you're going, you can tear through this pretty quick. This might be pretty cool to do speed runs on. Once we get to that point, I'm not sure that it will be, but it feels like it should be. Like, it seems like one of those games where you can actually get in there and do, like, real specific, real well-routed runs. I don't know that that's necessarily the case, but it feels like it. And to me, that seems like that might become a thing. Wow, I wasted a lot of time doing that. That was real dumb. Ooh, jeez. Uh-oh. That didn't work out. Let's try that again. Jeez, that's not an easy jump. Well, I guess it's easier than I thought. I don't know. Yeah, see, like, over here, it seems like there's gonna be a, like, a rock collapse, because it makes the noise, and there's a sign warning about it and everything, but nothing happens. Whatever. What's up, Jeep? Get alive, Jeep. I need some Autobots up in this shit. Alright, well, I wasn't too far behind. So, now we know, no, I don't need to go down that hole. That hole is not where I need to go. Yeah, that feels like a Metroid thing. Super does. So clearly, I'm supposed to go over here. At least this far. And I am supposed to fight that dude. And then right here, that... I'm clearly supposed to break through. But as it stands, I gotta find a way to get up this thing, I think. Is that what you're for? Yeah. Cool. Maybe? That doesn't do... That didn't do me anything. Alright, well. Oh. There we go. Want those medallions! Don't fall off! There we go. Yeah! The jumping and stuff, when it's actually happening, feels pretty cool. I don't need to Viper Strike on nothing. I'm just gonna slam through the ground here. Yeah, that's what I thought! A Soma facility. Wasn't that the drug in Morrowind? Oh no, that was Skooma. Those load times are getting a little better. Where are you? Storage cells, hey! Well, I didn't need any, so. Suck a nut ball. I want to go to detention. Ooh, I got some more audio logs.
September 17th, 1942. My name is Andrew Fisher, leading physicist and head of Project Pendulum.
Rid of fuel slugs.
And development project directed by the Army Corps of Engineers to produce a weapon of mass destruction that can bring an end to the war through the unconditional surrender of our enemies. In response to the spy-ridden efforts of the Manhattan Project, headed by my cohort, Robert Oppenheimer,
cohort
has been founded under the utmost secrecy. Funds, pride, and soldiers' lives are all on the line in a race to win the war, thus giving rise to the name Pendulum.
What'd that do? That do me anything? Oh. It's turning lights on. It's a big old warehouse. Missed. It's weird, even the powered up swarms only take 3 shots to hit. Ooh, is there another one? Oh, there is another one. Okay. Didn't even see him. Oh, no, it wasn't. It was just the ones he shot. Alright. Give me your power! Summer reactor. Alright. What do we got here? Got some more pipes to run through.
As a precaution to both Nazi and Soviet espionage.
Hey, I want that.
Pendulum's location and purpose is unknown.
I want that.
To the outside world.
I'll get that.
Taking a cue from the Manhattan Project.
Coming from above.
Only a small few know of Pendulum's purpose, operating under the guise of an alternative energy project.
Their lives are in your hands.
Had been plagued with espionage. It was agreed upon to shroud Pendulum within the government itself. All those who knew of Pendulum's true intent are here. Though as the extreme, we can ensure
that's a boost.
That umbrella of secrecy. Information can
I want that.
And none can go out. As far as anyone outside this valley knows, Pendulum does not exist. This valley does not.
Well, it's in Canada, so the Canadians probably know. Little broken dudes, huh? You can't aim all the way down, and that's kind of annoying. It's like down at an angle. The fuck? Getting some Bioshock kind of bullshit in here, huh? Andrew Fisher, isn't that close to the name too? Isn't it like Andrew Ryan or something? Due to the power strain. Cool. What's up, guys? That's me right now. That's what I look like. Whoop. I wanted to read it. I want to read it. What's it say? Finally got to see one of those orbs in the wild. There's a million of them. What are you talking about? You finally got to see one of them? Bitch, I've absorbed more orbs than you even know about. Supply drops, blah blah blah. Is there more to pick up in here? Look like it. Alright. Let's get a move on here. Oop. What's going on in here? See, some of these roots are dead. I'm sure that's not a problem, right? Hopefully she won't find you creepy, bro. I know that feel. Yeah, sure. Sure, why not? I feel like this is not a well-designed facility if these trees are just growing their roots right through it. 4 units energy? Sure, why not? Well, remember when I said that they weren't too hard until they probably threw more than one at me? Well, here we are. Now they're still not that hard. Whew. Hey, what's up, dude? Got your little swing line stapler there, too. That's good. Let's read this paper. A lot of reading here. I'm getting sick of your attitude, Ralph. These guys really didn't get along, huh? didn't get along, and they like to complain about it too. What's in here? One of y'all's large creature sightings. Okay. Am I gonna get some real combat in the game now? That'd be cool. I don't know if the game can handle that, though. I'm not sure if the gun mechanics and whatnot are gonna really hold up super well to, like, actual combat. Especially with such a limited, such a limited ammo source. I guess we'll find out. Anything around the top here? Yeah? Boxes. Empty boxes. Looking for some empty boxes, boys. You got any empty boxes around these parts? What we got? Please refrain from wasting office supplies. Stock is running low. So print it out on a piece of paper, why don't you? Do-do-do. Whatever. Alright, well. Let's move on. I'm gonna head out to where the trees are.
I can't believe it. I'm almost at a loss for words. This is the discovery of a lifetime. No, no. Of the 20th century. Have I found Schrodinger's cat? This is beyond my wildest imagination. As a result of the reaction between the Amrita energy and the Pathfinder's own life force, they experience what I have dubbed quantum death. When a Pathfinder dies while wearing
quantum
the
suit, death.
Their consciousness branches into a new
Where'd
reality.
You come from?
Unharmed, they achieve quantum immortality.
Oh, they're not even playing around about that, huh? It's just actual quantum immortality. We just die and then one of our existences in another reality doesn't. Cool. That is it's classic quantum immortality. I didn't realize they called it that just to do that, though. I'm gonna pee. Can I pee? Can I put my life energy in my pee? Hey! I grew mold. My pee grew mold! Using the God Hand. Mark 2. What level is mine? Is my suit a garbage suit? I want a good one.
Welcome to the Pathfinder program.
Welcome!
You've been selected among an elite few to participate in an experimental study to test out Pendulum's newly designed leaf suit.
Leaf suit? Alright, so this is where I am, and I gotta go that away to the Astra facility. Okay, let's do it. See, the outside bits are way cooler.
To produce bombs of unparalleled yield, we rely upon the life seed housed within a reactor found deep underground beneath the Soma facility. By harvesting the high energy yield orbs found within the valley, we pass their energy through the life seed, which acts as a sort of amplifier, magnifying the energy to unprecedented levels. The explosives we create here will dwarf anything the Manhattan Project could ever possibly fathom.
Ah, that military just blowing shit up. What do we got over here? Why are you all sparky? Oh shit, what's shooting at me? Give me your energy, bruh. There we go. I want to run really fast downstairs like that. Could you imagine? Gotta get to work, boys! Gotta get to work! Running down some stairs! Alright. Well, that looks like water, and water is known to kill me. Go. Yoink! No? Not gonna open? Did I miss something? There's a generator there, right? I shot it. Crane block. rock overhead. Oh, there it is. I was just on floor 2, and this is floor 5. There's not enough room in between me for that many floors, video game. I saw you.
The valley is suffering.
Yeah, see, I called this.
The natural life here seems to be slowly dwindling. Edwin thinks I'm crazy, but
we got... Oh, hey, Acorn Door. What's up, bro? How many do you need? 26! Yeah, no. Oh, I wonder what happens, man. That seems like if you save them up, you can get that. That sucks. Open the bay doors, Jim. Boop! Come on, dude, you ain't got shit. Fuck your swarms. Alright, what do we got? How do I get down below? Do I just drop? Kind of. Grr. It'd be so cool to be able to do that, just fall. Just be like, oh hey, I'm just gonna jump off a fucking building here. Hey, what's up, Frack? I see you in there. Aw, yeah, get that upgrade. What do we do now? Push rod piston maximum velocity upgrade. Cool. I can run faster. Oh, hey.
Our newly developed push rod pistons will allow pathfinders to achieve an unprecedented velocity. By energizing the tunnel rails, the
leech somehow I died there.
Conducts enough energy to reach immense speed.
That's cool. I'll take a speed upgrade all day. This should lead down to the reactor. Let's find out. Run on the rail to travel faster. Your energy will recharge from the tracks. That's cool. Oh, damn. See, when you do this kind of shit, it's cool. Whoa. Yep. Oh, what's up top? Do I want to go up there? I probably wanted to go up there. I ain't exploring. I'm just running. Must go fast. Gotta go fast. Yeah, it seems like there's all kinds of stuff to explore up there, but, ID gaff. Oh, I miss him. Fuck him. See, this shit's cool. Oh, jeez. I got it, we're good. We good. I don't know, it's just a shame that more of the game isn't just running like a maniac. That's a big hand. What's up, big hand? Give me a handy J there? There we go. That stands for hand jump for all the kids at home, in case you weren't aware. This feels kind of like the end of Portal, this chunk. Obviously in Portal you don't run fast, but like, just the way you're super powered compared to before. Man, I'm really trucking here. Gotta keep that upgrade, man. Aw, shit. I hit the wall. Uh-oh. Double jump? There we go. The only problem is this part of the game is literally on rails. Like, can't really make that one up here. We are literally on rails in this game at this point. It's cool, though. I feel like they spent a lot of time and energy, like, designing those big jump areas for shit you're never gonna see. Oh, that's cool. I think this would be pretty cool in VR. Get a real sense of speed. Let's get moving here. Can't shoot me. Take care of that one before it becomes a problem. There we go. Aw, that'd be cool if this was some fucking loop-de-loop thing. Whoa! Whoa! Hey guys, in case you didn't know that part was supposed to be cool, the music told me it was. And now back to slowly exploring some fucking abandoned facility. This game's pretty bipolar here. Like, the running stuff is super fun. Like, the running and the platforming and all that. But then just kind of farting around in these abandoned facilities isn't as fun. Is how I would put it, without being a dick. Isn't as fun.
That damned Oppenheimer.
Damn him!
A report just came in stating that Manhattan's first yield test was a surefire success. The explosion yielded 20 kilotons of TNT energy.
Dynamite!
At greater efficiency. But time is running out. I am ordering a 300% increase in production to meet quotas for a megaton blast yield produced in 3 days' time. Of course, our trump card lies in the Thanatos cannon prototype under development.
Of course.
Its power, unlike anything Oppenheimer could possibly fathom. With this technology, we'll become the closest thing to gods the world has ever seen!
That guy sounds real stable. He should be the scientist in charge of a weapons program. Okay, is that underwater? That is not underwater. Okay. Whoop! Make sure I don't break through the floor here. Hey, a button! What do I do with the button, boss? What's the button do? What door's opening? This one or that one? In theory, that one? Oh, that's cool. That's super cool, actually. See, this kind of thing's cool. I don't believe they built this in the 40s, but it's cool. Retrieve life seed. Gotta get into the reactor. That's a good question. Huh. I bet the tape tells me. Something here I need to...
What will happen to that?
We gotta have victory over Japan, obviously. Come on. That's when we used it. That's when we actually used the nuke. Only one passenger on the conductors can handle. What's the button do? Oh yeah, we're just gonna open up the core. Seems like a safe way to do things. What's going on here? Yeah, there we go. Gotta go get me a life seed. Let's do it. I guess that's what a life seed is. Yeah, there it is. Press E. It's pretty big. I don't know if I could take it. Apparently I can take it. Okay. I don't know what that means, but okay. Does that mean I'm all upgraded and shit? That's a good question. What the hell is Astra? I bet it's this door. Oh, is this an escape sequence? This might be an escape sequence. Hey, maybe we should have thought about finding out what that shit was first, huh? Cycles through the Soma reactor to be amplified and returned to Astra for weapon creation. The two facilities are interdependent on each other, like yin and yang, to maintain a balance. What's going on here? Oh, is it this way? No, there's a fence there too. Kidoke. I'm gonna go this way. Peace out. Oh shit. I'm trying to run here. What the fuck is that? Okay. The Astra Extractor pulls an energy typically from orbs to deliver to Soma, while the Soma reactor amplifies the energy and sends it back to Astra. I should probably cut my nails at some point. Holding down the shift key is getting annoying. That might be my biggest complaint, is that there's no, like, auto-run feature. And literally all you do is run. Oh, wow, I do way more damage. One hit and that does it. Okay, cool. Alright, so do more damage. Okay, that's cool. Okay. I'm down. I'm down with shit getting weird.
As a precaution, we cannot allow Astra to operate without a link to Soma. Otherwise, it will pull energy indiscriminately until it has robbed life from the entire valley, or even the entire planet. There should be enough energy within Soma's auxiliary reserves to...
Seems like a bad way to run things.
However, if the link to Soma is ever disrupted, Astra will need to be shut down immediately.
Yeah, that seems like a real wise way to run things. Yeah, I guess whose fault that is. It's mine! Oops. Sup, tree. I'm just gonna run into you. Those northern lights are cool. What the fuck is that?
They won't listen. The energy they're demanding from the valley is far outpacing whatever can be produced from the orbs. It's killing this place. And we'll lose it forever if we don't do something.
I mean, there's something up here. No doubt.
But this is larger than me. This valley. It could very well change the world. I have to save it before it's lost forever.
What's up, little spritesies?
Meow, 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 meow.
Yeah, you know what we should call these dudes? Demons! Supposed to be shooting life energy at him, or the other way around? Whoa. Okay. Those are like big demons. Okay. Calling these guys demons makes sense. You got me there, game. Shoot the fucker. There we go. Where else is there? Oh, he's up above. Little dick. Was I not supposed to go down here? Hmm. Where did they come from, indeed? I'm just gonna go around? no worries. I just went around. No problem, guys. We're good. There's no demons. Everything's all set. What's up, map? I mean, he's gonna be, like, right here. At least he should be. Oop! There's one. This sky's cool. The northern lights are always cool to see. We don't really get to see them down where I am, down here in upstate New York. Every once in a while, you'll see some green in the sky, but nothing crazy, nothing super cool, nothing like that. Of course, it's a video game too, but that's not the point. I know it's a video game, guys. There another guy over here? No? So, they went and made the normal things that can attack you easier to kill. That's not quite how I wanted that to go. Obviously, this dude over here wants a piece. You want a piece? I'll come over there. Don't think I won't. I play first-person shooters for fun. I'm not worried about you. Give me those acorns. What's in here? I sure would like more energy. That would probably be cool. I mean, I guess picking up orbs would solve part of that problem, but like, I want to have more energy stores. Time is at 9:01. Yeah, that seems not great. Explore town site for a way to breach the Astro facility. Or reach, instead, yeah. I don't want to bring all these trees back to life. Where you going, dickhead?
up, little sprites?
So I feel like I should probably bring some of these trees back to life in case I die. Yeah, see, there's another leaf on the valley. There's probably enough energy around here. I can get to full energy and do what I'm trying to do. That's something bad, right? Isn't that a bad looking thing? If there's a chivo for doing what I'm doing. Bringing them trees back. Well, let's see here. What happens if I go up top? Nothing, turns out. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go over the ramp here. Head north or farther out. Alright, let's... That's all of them? Okay. Running on these corrugated metal roofs is loud as hell! Acorns! I missed the winter months? Yeah? Alright, well, whoever made this game probably hasn't actually lived in the winter, because winter fucking sucks. Almost as much as summer. Almost. I'm telling you, if you could get spring and or fall year-round, that'd be the perfect place for me. For fall. Keep the leaves different colors, cool looking. Oh, hey, that's reasonable.
If only to make sure nothing happens to me.
Hey, what's up, Skull? This seems like a good place as any to be.
A weapon being built at Astra. Some sort of cannon. We should be able to use it to destroy Astra beyond reparation. Enough to shut down this project. Unfortunately, everyone is working round the clock with the increase in production, so we'll need to pull an alarm to get everyone out. We can then sneak into Astra through the underground tram tunnel that connects the two sites. No one should get hurt.
Possible Wendigo depiction.
To whomever may find this recording, please understand that Fisher has strayed beyond reason. If we don't put a stop to this madness, they could destroy this valley. And with power like this, maybe even the world. If we failed, please do whatever it takes to stop them.
What the fuck?
Too late.
Yeah, lady, that's a pretty reasonable picture to have front and center. As much as I love this valley, the thought of turning home. Alright, well. Let's get moving. Oh, that's fun. Bringing in some more dudes, huh? That's kind of cool. Hey, you got two big red eyes going on over there. It's totally normal, right? I see you. I'm impressed by you. I see you. I don't need your bullshit. Alright, can I go up? Okay. Wasn't sure I could make that jump. I'm opening doors with my hands here. No. Oh, shit.
Word has come in.
Jerk off.
To sabotage our operations at Area 634. The report indicates a soldier from the Pathfinder Division may have committed himself to treason by planning to use the Thanatos cannon prototype being developed at Astra to destroy the reactor. Came from a colleague of the alleged perpetrator, suspecting him as a potential Soviet operative. Since we only have one man's word to go on, we will need to catch him and any other accomplice in the act. As such, guards will be posted discreetly at Astra. Nothing will intervene with pendulum completion.
What do we got? More medallions. Give me them medallions. I'm telling you, if there's a pyramid and I can't go in it at the end because I didn't collect enough medallions, I'm going to be mildly annoyed. Alright, well, I guess I gotta go this way. Ah, yes. Cell block 1A. Private Lenny Watts has been reprimanded. You know what? Let me check and see if there's no boxes. Any boxes? Y'all got boxes in your prisons? Well, she's obviously got caught. Aw, music box. There's no context for that at all in the game. Other than just like, oh, this is a sad moment. Let's let them play sad music if they want. Like, she's not, like, a huge fan of some particular song or anything.
1945. Interrogating suspects involved in the attempted sabotage. Listen, just be upfront with us. Are you Soviet spies?
No! For the last time, this has nothing to do with politics.
All right, calm down. Just tell us your reasons.
You know how it's... Fisher has become. He's willing to destroy this entire valley to...
What the hell was that?
That sounds good. Let's follow the blood trails, because clearly that is the reasonable explanation here. Bro, it's like 1980. She's clearly long dead at this point. Like, it's at least the 80s in this game. And he's like, oh, is she alive? Being built in Astro to stir up some trouble. Cool. Ooh. Hey, there's a big face there. That couldn't mean anything, right? It's gotta be a good place to go. Ooh, fuck. Got time for your bullshit, bro. Weren't there three of them? Am I making that up? Apparently not. What's around the back? Looks like I had to go underneath, but I'm still gonna run around the back and see. Because they wouldn't have put it here for no reason, right? What do we got? A medallion. We good. You know, it'd be real cool if the moon actually looked like that. Is that everything? Like it. Alright, cool. I'm gonna go in that big mouth. right? Is that what's expected? Seems like that's what's expected. Let's open this box over here. Over yonder. Give me another medallion. A medallion. Yeah, this is how things should be done, is you go into the big spiky mouth part. Anything behind me before I go? Nope. Alright, let's get running. Omar. Thank you, sir. This is pretty dark in here. Is there a purpose for this place? A little hole there. Oh, doy. I wondered why the crosshairs turned green for a moment there. Oh, hey. Direction in this game. Upgrade! What up? What am I getting here? Run along magnetic wall surfaces. Sweet. Such as this guy? Hey, hey.
Private Hendrick,
doink.
I'm providing your squad
That's cool.
A newly devised magnetic core for your lease so that you may test its limitations.
Yep.
Take your squad to the train loading dock connecting to the tram tunnel.
I'm gonna go through this acorn butthole over here.
By the end of the day tomorrow.
24. Got 26. I'm good. What's up, Bigfoot? Hi. We got a little foot game. We got a little foot over there, too. Did Quentin Tarantino make this room? Because, damn. Those are some good-looking feet. And another upgrade. All right. It's probably just energy, but I'll take it. Yeah, I'll take that. I'll take more energy all day, every day. Alright, so those, like, high-level acorn doors seem to be just little side rooms like that with nothing huge. Anything below me? Nope. Gee, that seems a little shady. I don't know. Alright, where am I supposed to go here? Not down there, or... Oh. I don't want to be on the wall. Explore the train loading dock building. Which is up. Okay. There we go. Wasn't paying attention. I'm not thinking vertically. Do-do-do-do-do. Yeah, wow, there really isn't an auto run. I tried caps lock to see if maybe that would do it. There just isn't an auto run. Pshaw! Pshaw! Open up, eyeballs! Kill the valley? God damn it. Give me them acorns. Any tree I can get to, I think I'm going to bring back to life to see if I can get some more acorns, because both of the times I've had enough to get through one of those extra doors, it's been worth it. Hey! Just give me the damn acorn! Come on! There we go. Yoink. Alright, there anyone's around the back here? Yoink! Nope. Alright, cool. Let's head a little deeper. Acorn! Oh, I came up there, didn't I? Okay. Probably don't want to go that way, then. Yeah, you can backtrack dangerously far, it looks like. Although, now that I have this... Oh shit, don't do that! No! Go back on it, go back on it! Got a little cocky. Little cocky there. It's alright, we good. I've been here. Am I supposed to come back to here? I don't know what direction that is. Where am I? Jeez. Explore the train loading dock building. I don't know where that is. Is that here? Oh shit, that is here. Okay. Fuck out of here, bro. See, if you could run along these faster, it'd be way cooler. Oh, I got full energy, I'll take it. I'll take full ass energy. It turns out y'all motherfuckers ain't so tough, huh? It sounds like when you pick up acorns. Like, that water's not deep enough to kill me, and I guarantee you it does. Or shouldn't be deep enough to kill me, I should say. Yeah, suck that down, buttfucker. Oh shit, there's a... yeah, let's do it. Sucks to be them, huh? Follow tram tunnel to the Astro Weapons facility. Oh, I get to run on tracks again? Hell yeah! Sorry, but this rules. In response to the recent sabotage, oh, I guess I'll play the tape here. I am ordering all Pathfinder operations to be suspended, and all leaf suits to be locked away until project completion. The suits are too powerful to fall into the wrong hands. Additionally, I am requesting all evidence of the sabotage attempt, including Private First Class Edwin Hallroad leaf suit and Miss King's recordings, to be gathered and sent to storage until a proper military tribunal can take place. Until then, all suspects will remain in detention. With the recent increase in production, it should not be long. So that must have been where my suit came from, I guess? There's some shit below. There's like another set of train tracks below. I don't want to mess with anything if I don't know where I'm going, but... It does look like it's caved in. Oh, this looks like a fucking peach. Well. Alright, let's give it a try. Doink! Oh, shit! Yeah, I don't... That's what I figured would happen. Alright, so that goes up and down and around. No, that should go all the way. Why did it not? Maybe I was just being stupid. Yeah, you know what? I was just being stupid. This totally goes all the way. What's up, water? Just imagine doing this in real life. Just getting... Oh, I'm just running on the wall. Don't mind me. Just, hanging out. Hey, where's my boys? What were they called? Buck Rider! There we go. On my street, people! On my Buck Riders! Hey, that's cool. Maybe if the darkness could go away and I could see. There we go. Oh yeah, I'm gonna run down a hill. I'm gonna jump over a thing. Woo! Yes, it must. What's this thing? Anything around here? Caution. Live ammunition. Yeah, that's what I thought. I know there was something there. Oh. Wasn't even worth it. Alright. Looked like a revenant. Like I'm just a skeleton with a rocket launcher on my back right now. As far as this game's concerned. What's up, Flashy Bros? What's up, Bunny Rabbit? Hope I have enough acorns to get through this. Through this shit. They're not confident in me having enough, so they gave me a few dead trees here. How many you take? What do you got? 8. I got 8. 8 is great! Ooh, shit! Didn't see him. Ooh, wow. Didn't see that one and ran right the fuck into him like an idiot. That is pretty typical. Pretty typical gaming here. Alright, let's go up this way. The orbs mean there's something up here, so what do we got? All my street people! All my book riders!
Bye.
Excuse me, sorry folks. That one sneaked out. I usually try to avoid doing that, but... Whoop. Whoop. Can I double jump again? Ooh, I can. Hell to the yeah. Whoop. Ooh, that's... shouldn't have done that. Aw, no! Sorry, Valley. Alright, let's try that again. See, I got too cocky there. And didn't actually make a go at it. Hey, what's up, obelisk? What do you got? You got some shit around you I need to put life into? That sounds dirty as fuck. Hey yo, obelisk, how you doing? You got some shit what needs life put into it? Doesn't look like it. I'm gonna put life into you, girl. You're gonna like it. It's made out of life beams from my hand. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. Alright, what do we got? Alright, well. No need for that. Did I come from? I came from that way. There's an arrow. That's the way I gotta go, guys. Whoop. Whoop. Jeez, this is the wrong way. Ooh. Ooh, get it. You asshole. Asshole fucking... whatever the fuck you're called. Continue towards Astro Valley. Those... whatever those swarms are called. Oh. Oh, I'm not going fast enough for this at all. Oops. Sorry, Valley. This valley is not in great shape right now. So... go. Alright, now I'm going fast enough. Whoop! There we go. Give me some of these. Trying to give the valley some life back so that I don't get completely fucked if I die again. I mean, the game has explicitly said that if there's no more life left in the valley, you can't come back to life. So I'm gonna assume that they actually hold you to that. Alright. I'm gonna run. We got this. Rawr! There we go. Oh, okay. They're like right there. There we go. Easy enough. Got a few more of y'all up there. I'll go get you. We're good. Yeah, you're not so tough now, huh? Those ones seem like they're stronger, but they're definitely not. Like, they take three hits just like everybody else. Alright, I need to recharge my energy here a little bit. Alright. Let's head forth and see what we got.
April 24th, 1943. What is the significance behind these colossal statues found throughout the valley?
It's a good question.
I find they all look so very voracious. I keep returning to the idea of the mythical Saiteka, the legendary tribe of cannibalistic giants that roamed North America and came into conflict.
Oh, that's a cool looking sunrise.
But why would they be worshipped?
Yeah, hopefully I don't have to fight a giant cannibal, because that would suck. Alright, well, that clearly isn't where I was supposed to go. Or is it? Seems like that's where I was supposed to go, right? Maybe across? What's down here? Okay. Yeah, you know, oh, right. I was supposed to go up there, but then I was supposed to break through the floor instead of being stupid. There we go. So, the parts of this game when you're running super, super fast and you're just moving on instinct and jumping over shit, like, that part's super duper fun.
Virginia King,
18, really? I mean, if that's what those dudes that I'm fighting are, they're not very tough. And they probably hold a strong cultural significance because they're there and real. Get that other tree. That the magic fireflies are drawn to. Did that open that door down there? I feel like that's why it would let me go that way. Yep, cool. Kill. I need one more frickin'. If I have one more acorn, I could go open that acorn door too. he drop one? He did not drop one. Got a medallion. I'll take a medallion. Ah, well. Almost. Ooh, hey. This must be that pyramid. Well, hopefully 25 is enough to get in, because that's what I got.
The pyramid built by the Saurians served as a ceremonial structure.
30! Book! Okay, well.
Along with the Titan Tree and Daemons, they intertwine to form a mythology. From what I gathered, the Colossi were once humans who feasted upon the forbidden fruit, corrupting them into giant monstrosities, cannibalizing their fellow man and devouring all life within the valley. Are the Saurians warning us against abusing the power of the life seed?
Well, I don't have enough to get into the building. That sucks. That's the way I came from. Let's see what's out this way. I wonder if that's just it. It's like, well, nope, can't go in. Sorry. There's another way in. What's up, dear? What's up, other deer? Oh, did I not need to even come here? It seems like that might actually be the case. Because the place I gotta go is the pretty much the place I came from, looks like. Yeah, see, I gotta go that way. Ooh, there's a lot of them down here. Oh, there's a green one. Is he stronger? Nope. You know, he probably just shoots faster. And moves faster. Shit, what the fuck? There we go, good lord. That almost got ugly. Almost died in combat. Oh, okay. Yeah, you know what? That part is totally optional, and, sucks. Oh, what happened there? Well, that jump didn't go well. Five off, that sucks. Leaf suits are very heavy equipment. Yes, I know, thank you. I'll put me way down here? That sucks. You know, I could have made that jump if I grappled onto that that thing properly. Let's get some energy back here. There we go. Let's try that again. Yeah, if I just grappled onto that thing right, I would have been fine. See, look at that. It wasn't that hard at all. I was going like half the speed, too. Yeah, I kind of need to bring some things in here back to life before I die a few more times. Just in case. Yeah, see, the valley's in doing decent health now. Alright. Hey, you keep shooting shit at me, bro. I'm just gonna go. Did I just bring those vines back to life? That sucks. Wait. Oh, hey. I didn't know you could bring the roots and stuff back to life. That's interesting. What the fuck was that? Apparently they can travel. Interesting. I need the energy to be recharged pretty bad. I don't really need to bring more of the valley back here because, according to the little thing there, the valley energy is pretty good, so I'm not gonna fuck around with that right now. See, the bits in the game when they let you just run and have fun in the air are super fun. I wish more of the game was like that. Give me an upgrade. What do we got? Lake Skipper. Pathfinders run across water for limited duration. Your speed will increase as you run. Okay. I'll take it.
I have tasked the Valkyrie Pathfinder squad with testing out the Lake Skipper upgrade for the Lake Skipper.
How far can I run across the water? Is it three clicks of the... Like, is it three? It's probably three, I would imagine, right? It's more than three. See, this shit's fun. I'm not really doing anything, but like just running around and launching off of shit is fun. Like, alright, clearly it starts to sound bad if I can't run on it anymore. See, just let me play this like first person Sonic the Hedgehog and don't give me all this other goofy shit that isn't as fun. And this game would be great. Like, I get what they're going for, you kinda gotta mix it up to make this part seem more interesting and all that shit, but like, nah, you could make a pretty legit game doing this. I don't mind the combat, it's the part where it slows down when you're like in the buildings that kinda sucks. That's the part I'm not in love with. Like, the graphics in this are pretty great. Oh, shit. I wasn't sure that was a low enough angle to... It says you have to land on the water at a low angle. So I wasn't sure if I was just gonna belly flop into it right there. That run speed, it's a good run speed. Whoop. Like, if most of the game was just running, I really do think it would be a lot more fun. It's not bad by any means, but I don't know. It's very, very linear, and if you're gonna make a game this linear, there should be a lot more running. There we go. I totally missed that dude saying that run speed. Ah well. Breaking and enter. David was all panicky. Oh. Yeah. That was obvious. Shouldn't have done that. Yeah, thanks for the reminder. Literally every time I die in the water. Thanks. I guess I gotta go up? Can I stand on the pipes? I can. Okay. Am I supposed to stand on the pipes is the question. Well, doesn't matter, because I am, so. Whoops. Like it appears I should be going up, right? Gotta be, because there's nothing over here. Except for you. Hello, I didn't see you. Are you a thing? I don't know if those are the magnetic plates or not. Oh, doy. Hood doy! Those are. There we go. So, which way is the... Jeez, that's confusing. Alright, so I'm on the wall. Let's go over this way. There we go. That's the ground, right? That's the ground. Okay. Yeah, the parts where you just get to run and do like a little bit of platforming stuff, those parts are fun. But then you come back inside. And then you come inside and you have to deal with some industrial facilities and stuff, and like, that part could be cool too. But they chose not to make it super fun. Actually, I'm sure they didn't choose not to make it super fun, but it ended up not being super fun. Let's put it that way. Yeah, what are these guys doing down here, little duders? So I have the life seed now, like, shouldn't they not be able to suck life from the valley anymore? Isn't that the understanding I had earlier? I guess not. Oop. Boink! I didn't even know that was water. Oh, shit! Whoop. Almost not making some of these jumps here. Come on. Oh, well. That didn't go well. You know, if you go too fast, you're not below, you're not underneath these things, and... I don't see how I'm supposed to make this. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do there other than what I just tried to do. I don't know, it just doesn't seem like I'm coming through here fast enough to get to those things on the other side. Ah, there we go. That time I was. Yoink! Let's see. Which way? Is it this way? Ooh, shit! I don't know which way's down. Alright, there's you. So that's down, which means I need to go... There we go, Jesus Christ. Alright, let's put some life back in this place because I'm fucked otherwise. Can't shoot those ones. Okay, it's fine. Yeah, this valley's almost dead and so am I. Find a way to shut down the facility. I'm trying. Trying to shut down that facility. What do we got? Anything interesting? Alright, there's one more leaf. I think every time I die, it's like two leaves. Seems like. Leaves. Alright. Yeah, what happened here indeed? Need to put those leaves back on that tree. Alright, well, let's head down. Oh boy, I bet this isn't a boss battle of some sort. Those things are all clustered together. Yeah, I bet there's a fight. Feeding ground. What the fuck is going on? Oh, so these fucking giants are real, huh? That sucks. Nope. Bye-bye. So he's got a little shield. Whoa! Yo, you don't get to double dip. He did the little explosion thing, and then it hit me and knocked me back. And it fucking knocked me into it again. Jesus, what the fuck? Go back to the other way. Get out of there. Shouldn't I be able to run, like, way faster than this? Isn't that sort of the whole point of the entire game up till here? I think I killed it too. Are you kidding me? Like, it sucks that shooting... Oh, wow. I did kill it. Okay. See, it kind of sucks that shooting things... takes away your energy, which is also your health. Like, that is kind of shit. That was kind of cool. It's just, like I said, your health and your ammo being the same thing are shitty. That is super shitty. Imagine a weapon of mass
Thanatos cannon will be the optimal super weapon, rendering all others obsolete. These bombs we're all competing to produce will look paltry in comparison.
Ooh, that's a big one. Hey, big one. You're a big ol' bomb. Hold on a sec, my dog's barking. I guess the girlfriend's home. Alright, so we're... Here we go. Hoop! What time is it? It's only 9:50. Okay.
August 16th, 1944.
You knew about this the entire time, didn't you?
Vivisection. Twist. I mean, to be fair, they don't seem sentient. We do way worse things with other animal eggs, right? Other things that we don't call demons? Hmm? Sabotage.
Access into the Astra facility during their night of attack. Admittedly, their plan was rather genius. Since Astra and Soma are linked, they intended to fire the Thanatos cannon connected to Astra's thermal storage at the Soma facility's energy reservoir to create a feedback loop of amplifying intensity until the system blows out. Not unlike a microphone to a speaker.
I can finish it. Create a feedback loop. I wonder how I do that. Do I just push a button? Oh.
We had temporarily removed the life seed from the Soma reactor necessary for the amplification, thus creating a harmless feedback loop when they attempted to fire Thanatos. Without the life seed, their plan was doomed to fail from the beginning. I will not tolerate any more disruptions.
Oof.
We have lost too much ground to Manhattan. Operations will resume exponentially. If the orbs will not suffice...
Do I have to get in the cannon and be shot? That'd be cool. Here we are. See, this could look super cool, but I don't know. That cloud cover doesn't really work. Alright, let's see here. Is there a button somewhere I gotta pull? Boop. Like I said, I think I gotta get in this thing. Jeez. I guess that'll do it, huh? don't know where those corridors are. Alright, if they're gonna do like a Super Metroid style escape and it's actually fun to play, then this could be super cool. But I don't know that they're gonna. Asshole scared the shit out of me. Run across this stuff? Oh no, here we go. Doink! Doink doink! I should probably not waste any energy on stupid shit. Kill them both? I think I killed them both. Guess I did. Alright. Door gonna close? Door's not gonna close. This place is flooding here. I need to get out. Where is... Oh. Here we go. Anything coming down at me? Don't look like it. I wish these made you run faster like the rails did. Let's get out of here. Oop. Oh, shit. Oh, God. Ooh, just barely. I got enough speed to do that. Out of the cannon. Whoop! Hopefully I can run across the water. Nope. I'm taking my suit off. Gotta swim to the surface, guys. On something. I think there's a decent speedrunning opportunity in this. There seems like it. Feels like there's a few parts I got through as fast as you can possibly go, maybe, but...
Power to control the world will lie within the hands.
civilization on Earth will travel.
What I look like when I poop after eating some hot wings. Nobody needs to know that. Why do I even say that shit? So, I'm gonna say there's probably more than one ending, based on the fact that I couldn't get into the pyramid. I'm gonna go ahead and say that that's, maybe there's like a best ending that includes that. Ah, but that game wasn't terrible. It's out on PC, it's on Steam. Wanna say it's on Good Old Games too? I'm gonna watch the credits just because I think there's a, it's probably Chivo for it. Let's see here. Oh, maybe not. Yeah, no, alright. So, that's Valley. It's made by Blue Isle Studios. They're the company, like I said before, that made the Slender Man The Arrival game. This is a lot different atmospherically. Yeah, it's on PC, Xbox, PS4. It's $20. Like, that's a reasonable price for the game that I just played. If that had been a full price game, probably would have been very upset. But for $20, that's a decent little game. The atmosphere is really nice. The gameplay is really nice when you're running around. The parts inside the facilities, maybe not so much, but the outdoor bits are very, very fun. That part's super fun. Dude's name is J.F. Bursnatches. It's a pretty tight name. Helg Eshad Balerion. I didn't expect to beat that in one sitting like that, honestly. But I did, so there you go. I guess we'll call this a let's play of the game, too. Hey, what's up, Risley? It's a decent game. Not amazing. If you liked what you saw, it's probably worth a run through at least once just to see how well done the running is, but the stuff in between is not amazing, so it's worth $20 for sure. We're gonna sit through the end credits just because I didn't plan on beating the game. These people might as well get credit for whatever it is they did. The game is done already. I literally just beat it. There's a lot of people in these credits. What am I planning on playing right now? Probably nothing. We hit our allotment today. It's close to 10:30. I'm off at 10:30, so I'll let these credits run through and see from there. So for those of you who did watch, obviously you see I didn't get into the pyramid, which means I probably didn't get a secondary ending there, so there's still reason to play. You go find more secrets, you can get into that pyramid. The music in this is really nice. I like the soundtrack's pretty good. The sound design's okay. The enemies are but like I said, there's a very Metroid Prime feel to a lot of the platforming, and that part is super fun. I just wish it kept you at speed more, I guess. A lot of people in these credits lists. These must be like Kickstarter backers or something. I don't think they kickstarted this, but maybe they did. Let's see. That just seems like an incredibly long list of names there. I guess this was kickstarted. Okay. Didn't know that. That means this might go on literally forever. Or maybe not. I mean, it would have to be with all these names. I'm not finding anything out there obviously about it, but that's because they named the game Valley. And that is a fucking generic name if ever there was one. Gameplay, Blue Isle Studios. I mean, why else would they have a list of names this long? This many people didn't work on it. I didn't actually pay attention to what it said either, so. So yeah, that wasn't a bad game. I don't know that I would necessarily go back and redo it unless I decided to get into some kind of speedrunning competition or something like that, but $20. It's worth $20. It's a night out at the movies, right? Night out at the movies for about 3.5 hours of entertainment versus, you know, 90 minutes of crap. And yeah. Yeah, we're gonna skip those credits. I said skip. There we go. Let's see what happens after the credits. Nothing? Nothing. 2 hours and 30 minutes. It's a decent time. So yeah, there you go. That was Valley by Blue Isle Studios. Well, I guess we're going to call it for the night. That's pretty much everything I had. Yeah. Thanks for joining us, folks. Feel free to give us a follow here on Twitch if you're feeling frisky. At the top here, you can see our little social media accounts. We got Facebook, we have a Twitter page, we have an Instagram. We use all of those. If you want to get a feel for when we're going to be on, that sort of thing. We actually have a schedule on our website. Our website is forcequit.work, and I'll actually put a link to the schedule here in chat. So yeah. Check us out. Give us a follow. We're streaming pretty much every single night. There's four dudes. There's me. My name's Hammer. My buddy Condor. My buddy Ghosty. My buddy Cthulhu. We all play different kinds of games. I'm kind of the indie dude. The other ones are all over the board, too. So take a look. Take a look at the page. Take a look at our bios, which I'm putting in here, too, to get a feel for who you want to watch. And we're also on YouTube. All of our old videos are archived there. Usually once they drop off of Twitch, they're still there. So here's all our YouTube information, too, if you want to take a look. We do more than just streaming. We've started to do a few like short, quick-look reviews called Forced Looks instead of First Look. Yeah, we're a funny bunch. And that's about it. So, yeah, thanks for stopping by tonight. Give us a follow. Do whatever. You can come back later if you want. Take a look at the schedule, and we'll be here. So thanks for joining. Have a good evening.